President Museveni is currently in self-isolation at the State House in Nakasero, having tested positive for COVID-19 last week. Since then, Ugandans have continued to shower the president with love, wishing him a quick recovery. This morning, NRM supporters conveyed at the president's main entrance at Nakasero to deliver him get-well messages and flowers. Religious leaders from all denominations also gathered at the office of the president in Chambogo today, where they held special prayers for the president's recovery. The prayers have been led by Reverend Canon Dr. Rebecca Margaret Nyegenye from All Saints Cathedral, who was also joined by Second Deputy Mufti of Uganda Sheikh Muhammad Waiswa, among other leaders.
We are looking to God and Him alone because He's the healer. The doctors are playing their part, but the healing power belongs to the Lord. And that is why we have gathered together. You can clap because the power belongs to the Lord. So we are here because the power belongs to the Lord. And we are here to know and to appreciate the work of the doctors. They are working so hard. We want our president up, but we are trusting that God, who is able, in his able hands, will be able to draw closer to him.
The president's young brother, Cedric Nzeire, was among the scores of people who turned up for these prayers. He informed the country that the president's health has improved and will soon be able to get back on track.
Since Mukama, Mwebaza, Wakwaya, Onye, President Wafe, Omzade Wafe, Era, Tubebazanyo, President Yat Gambia, Onye, Chokacha Kumichi, a minister of Vedas Kirin, Tachari Mbuzu, Tumera Kira, Mukoremi Mojamwe, Nayakum Pitan came Rumoje, Mwebarenyo, Okturinza, Chokanam Musasa, and Yenji, Umbantu and Bagam, the President Taina Chizubu.
The grandchildren of this nation. So, we had to come up together as a dynamic team to pray for His Excellency, our grandfather, because I don't think it's the right time for him to leave us. We shall remain orphans, and of which we pray highly to God to add him extraordinary life, to guide him, as well as guiding us.
He, however, advised Ugandans to stay vigilant and follow standard operating procedures. Report by Juliet Namoya for the news.